Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you how to install new fonts on your Mac. So when you're working in an app like Pages, you of course can change things about the text. And one of the things you can change is the font. So if you go over to the Format sidebar, go to Style, go to Font in Pages, you can choose the font. And I can go from Helvetica to say something like Impact. And you can see I've got a different font there. Now, chances are I've got a lot more fonts than you do because I've been collecting fonts for a long time. I bought several large font collections and added them to my Mac. So you may only have a limited set and you may not have something that really expresses what you want for the piece of text that you are styling. So what can you do to add fonts to your Mac? Well, you can go to the internet and you can get more fonts. Now the problem is what fonts are legal and which fonts aren't. So I've gone to two websites here that appear to have some fonts that you can freely download. But if you search the web for free fonts, you're going to come up with all sorts of sites. And some of them have fonts that are actually free. Some of them have fonts that aren't really free. They're just basically belong to somebody and somebody stuck them at a website. And when you download them and use them, you're actually violating copyright. And you have a ton of fonts that are in the middle, a gray area, where it might be free to actually download them and use them yourself. But if you print them out and distribute them, say, to other people at your company or friends, then you're actually violating the license without purchasing. It's very complex. But sometimes you just run into a situation where you go to a website and they offer you a free font and you download it and you need to know how to install it on your Mac. So I've actually identified two sites here that I think have free legal fonts. But I'm no lawyer, so I don't know for sure. The League of Movable Type is one, and another one that seems to be legit is fontlibrary.org. And if you wanted to download fonts from these, you would simply go to the font. So I've looked on this site and I found this one here, and there's a download button. So I'll click the download button, and you can see it throws that in the download folder. Here, I'll do the same thing. Let's find a font here. This one looks good, and there's a download button. I'll click on that. So now I've got two fonts that I've downloaded into my downloads folder and I could see them both here. Now let's see what I need to do with them to put them on my Mac. So I'll start by going into the downloads folder here, see what we've got. And we've got two folders here and there's a bunch of stuff. Every time you seem to download a font from somewhere, there's always a ton of stuff and it's hard to know what's important. So let's look at this one here, and I've got a bunch of different files, and what I'm looking for is something that's got an extension that's either TTF or OTF. They're the most common. OTF means open type font, and TTF is true type font. And they're both different types of fonts, both of which work just fine on your Mac. So how do you install this? Well, actually all you need to do is double click it. And it will open up this little window here. And it's actually opening up an app on your Mac that you might not even know you had called Fontbook. And in this window it's showing you the font, and you can actually take a look at the different styles. In this case there's only bold. And you can hit the Install Font button. So let's do that. And that's all it took. I've actually got that installed now. Now once I'm in Fontbook, I can actually look on the left side here and see various things like collections and lists and things like that. It actually looks a little bit like, say, Photos or iTunes here with the left sidebar. I can look at all my fonts, all the fonts installed on the computer, and the fonts that are just installed for this user on the Mac. And in this case, it is installed this font just for this user. I can see it right there, League Spartan. And I can open it up and see that there's just bold. Let's look at the other font there in the Finder, Railway Sans. And in here, it doesn't seem like there's anything here at the main level. And Docs and Source probably aren't what I want. But the Fonts folder actually shows me an OTF folder and a TTF folder. That's great. So we can go into either one of those and we can actually select that font. It does give you a preview, by the way, either in column view or, say, if I wasn't in column view, I can hit the space bar and look at do the quick look thing and see it. I'm going to double click on it and it's going to do the same thing here. It's just a regular version of the font, no bold or anything. I'm going to hit install font and it's going to do the same thing here. So now under my user for this Mac, I've got now these two fonts that I've installed. So now back in Pages, what we actually want to do is we want to quit Pages and start it up again to make sure that the new fonts are brought into the font menu. So now I can select this here and I should find those there. And there's League Gothic. I could switch to that. And if I go down to ours, I should find Railway. There we go. And I could switch to that. And that's how easy it is to add fonts to your Mac.